The Magic Flute is just about acceptance of different kinds of people and different ways of life. There are amazing, amazing contrasts in this piece. Musically, Mozart uses folk songs and hymns, and then he goes back to Baroque style for a couple of numbers, and then to sort of modern, more chromatic style. He mixes everything. It's about small chamber music numbers, it's about big finales, and it's also about the different singers. The piece goes very, very low. The sarastro is a bass, so he sings very in the low range of his voice. He sings down here. So that sounds pretty low, and it's accompanied by the trombones, which make it sort of sound sort of in a beautiful way, majestic, but more like a hymn. And on the other hand, we have the Queen of the Night, and she's singing up here. So it's an amazing, we have people singing down here and people singing up here. Papageno, the famous half bird like creature, he's a simple guy. And his melodies are simple, and the music is classical, and it's in a simple kind of rhythm. When Papageno and Pamina meet, it's amazing how Mozart uses the most simplest means, but manages to create the most beautiful melodies and duets. So, for example, in the orchestra you just hear, which is almost nothing, and as an answer, the woodwinds play. Now, the orchestra accompaniment alone carries on just like this, which is very, very simple. But then, of course, one of Mozart's just beautiful flowing melodies, I think that nobody else could write so simply as he could, and yet so beautifully. Mozart only existed for music and with music. He was born like that. He was composing when he was 6, 7, 8, 9. For him, it came so naturally. It's so well composed. The whole structures, the melody, the harmony, it fits so well together, and yet it's never boring. It's magical. It's really magical in that sense.